you have a 3D printer running Clipper, you basically have three options when it comes to user interface: Mainsail, Fluid, or OctoPrint. When setting up a new printer, you need to make a choice on which of those top-level applications you want to use. If you want to switch or upgrade the software altogether, you need some way of getting that new software onto the printer. Most printers running Clipper will have a dual setup with a Raspberry Pi and a separate real-time control board. The Raspberry Pi has a microSD card that you eject and transfer software directly from a computer. Recore combines the application processor and the real-time processor in a single board, and also has a permanent storage medium in the form of an eMMC, the same as all modern smartphones. Because the eMMC is mounted permanently, there needs to be a different approach to installing software. I've chosen USB as a separate boot medium, but I've never really been completely happy with how you choose which medium to boot from. A while back, I made an application called Reflash that allows installing new software on Recore. It's a two-step process where you first download or upload an image to the USB drive, and secondly, you flash that image onto the eMMC. The previous solution for going back and forth between the USB and the eMMC involved changing the kernel command line. It was done automatically by a plugin for OctoPrint and some added functionality to Mainsail and Moonraker. This meant that in order to use upstream Moonraker, Mainsail, and Fluid, a bunch of pull requests were needed. And because this is functionality that's very specialized for this board in particular, chances are it would not be accepted easily. So when looking at alternatives for this, I did an experiment with Reflash as a separate application running alongside the top-level printer application, just on a different port. So the idea was that every time you wanted to make a system change, you could use this other application, and it wouldn't have to be integrated in the same way via a plugin or a pull request. And that worked well, but there's no smooth way of going back to the Reflash app from the main app. Also, it's a bit of a security concern to have an app running in all times that allows you to enable SSH. Instead, it would be great to have something physical to access that higher security level. Because as soon as you have physical access to the printer, you can basically do anything regardless. And so I thought of the idea of always booting to Reflash as long as the USB drive with Reflash was inserted. This sort of breaks my rule of having everything on that board software-defined, but it does plug that security hole. This presented a problem though. After the flashing is done, the user must be prompted to remove the USB drive before rebooting in order to boot into the newly installed image. But how can you remove the root partition that the system has booted from? The solution might be obvious for sysadmin. You just let the whole OS live in RAM, init RAMFS. On an embedded system with 1 GB of memory and a server written in Python, that old image was too fat. It needed slimming. A friend recommended using Go, which can easily compile statically linked binaries for different platforms, and it has a great native library for making backends. The whole server takes 8 MB of storage and no dependencies. The whole image is also more portable and now takes less than 100 MB compressed. This also required me to rewrite the ncurses-based application that is visible on the embedded screen during flashing. It was also written in Python and has its own limitations with single size fonts and no graphics. Another friend showed me a quick demo of using the frame buffer, so I went low level and spent the day adding that to the main application directly. I'm using FreeType to display the text here, and the logo is made using basic 2D operations, mostly synthesized by the chatty generative pre-trained transformer. Now for a bonus feature. When friend 2 visited, we did some testing of the read and write speed of the USB versus eMMC, and it turned out that the USB itself is a little slow. So we thought, why not bypass that bottleneck and pipe the program from the internet directly into the eMMC? So that's what this magic mode does, and then it takes 3 minutes to completely flash a new image. And so once that operation is completed, you are prompted to remove the USB drive in order to complete the process. And that also ensures that the board is then rebooted into the newly installed app. In my opinion, this workflow works well from a usability standpoint. It is also more secure, requires less integration, and is much faster. Plus, you get the option to always go back to a known working state without requiring a serial port. Okay, that's all I have for this time. See you in the next one.